Speaking of boo houses, I hear you got the heebie-jeebies scared out of you when you covered this story.
No, those are just rumors. As a matter of fact, it was Calvin Green who was jumping around. We had to fix the camera and everything.
You told me you were jumping around a little bit.
No, it was Calvin. It was Calvin. It's officially Halloween week, and to kick it off, I visited a haunted house unlike any other. Now, this one is so spooky, so gory, so frightful, it should come with a warning label. Greg Baker is the mastermind behind the exercise in terror. One trip through his haunted house, you'll be convinced he lives for this time of year. That's why he's the focus of tonight's West Side Story. Baker is a master of disguises. His masks and costumes have been used in movies and commercials. His makeup techniques are incredible, and his love of gore will make the hair stand up on the back of your neck. The drama club at Countryside High School is enjoying this opportunity to test their acting skills. Children and even adults going through this haunted house are scared.
Some kids have gone running through, and they'll just like scream and freak out.
One kid just went out the other end. She was just sat there on the floor screaming. It's like, get me out of here, get me out of here, and they just turn around.
You like scaring little kids?
Yeah. The littler the better. The louder they are.
They cry.
Like I said, this place should come with a warning label. It costs $4 for adults to go through, $3 for kids 12 and under, and some of the money goes to Big Brothers Big Sisters. Greg tells me this year's show is twice as big, with more realistic sound effects and lighting than ever before.
Definitely. This is the biggest show, the most monsters. We've got the best crew. I mean, just all the kids here have just been better than anything we've ever had.
To give you a little taste of what it's like going through with things jumping out at you, grabbing for you, and repulsing you, take a look at some of what you will see.
This one, my uncle, he got the plane crash. This is Uncle Henry. He doesn't know where his legs are. Oh, no! I won't let her hurt you. She's just not feeling too well today. But come, please, come right in.
You probably don't need this advice after seeing a sample of the show, but real small children should not see this show. And if you don't like scary movies, you might stay away from here, too. But if someone teases you into coming along anyway, pay your $4. And as soon as that rat drops the bloody hand at the entrance, sprint for the back exit. It's a spooky show.
It really looks like it.
Yeah. Really.
A local high school graduate now has the biggest prize in the television industry, an Emmy. 27-year-old Bill Corso won the award for individual makeup achievement in a miniseries. You might have seen Corso's work in the ABC miniseries The Stand, seen here on WWSB Channel 40 in May. He had to turn glamorous movie stars into hideous monsters and make others look decades older. Fresh off his Emmy win, the Booker High School graduate is working on his next project, a movie called The Species.
And another Sarasota man has a knack for the make-believe. Greg Baker creates amazing masks that are so lifelike, seeing is truly believing. News 40 photographer Jim Waltz takes us behind the scenes.
At first, when I was a kid, I was into magic. That was the first thing. It's fooling people. You know, the illusion of fooling somebody, even scaring somebody, is a blast. Everybody likes to get scared. But I started off doing magic tricks and stuff with all those Ronco magic kits. And then basically, through the artwork and stuff, got into this. And we made 5 or 6 items for him, sent them up. That's all we had time for, because we met at the last minute. The 5 items that he got were the only 5 that were talked about in the whole show. Everything else was store-bought, and nobody was really interested in it. And so he called me back the next year and said, would you like to do the entire show? We have total creative control. We get to sculpt it, paint it. It's our own ideas. He gives us some ideas of what he wants, and then we get to come up with the rest. This is the dinosaur theme. These are some of the props that we created for them. We've got, each show is going to have 2 raptors. And one of these spitter dinosaurs and 1 pterodactyl. We've got a pig man, we've got an iguana man, insect man, and an alligator boy. And they have sets of hands that go with the heads also. I've got them on the back table. Basically, they're puppets. They're not made too articulate because they'll break down after somebody beats them for a whole month. The show is supposed to last for a whole month. So we had to build everything as sturdy as possible.
The show that Greg is talking about is a big Halloween exhibit in Kentucky, so that's where all of that's heading.
Oh, too scary for me.
SNN, you're guaranteed to be spooked by this story. Don't go away.
King 6, SNN, Sarasota News Now.
Friday the 13th may be over, but the terror is just beginning. SNN's Colleen Gallagher visited a haunted house at Gulfgate Mall, and we warn you, what you're about to see is not for the weak of heart.
It's no walk in the park. These high school volunteers are giving it their all to put a little terror into your Halloween spirit.
I don't know. I heard it was really scary.
The dead things walking around.
What if someone grabs you?
I'll jump. She's going to protect me.
The House of Horror is sponsored by the Bradenton Lions Club, and a few dollars will get you in the door. But getting out is another story.
Well, it may not be Halloween yet, but this place is definitely scary. So grab your parents, grab your friends, grab your brothers and sisters, grab someone, because you're going to be scared. It's open until October 31st, so come on down before it's too late!
From somewhere in the Gulfgate Mall, Colleen Gallagher, SNN.